Welcome viewers to TV Box Top, and today's video features a Windows 10 mini PC from the Treykey brand. This is the Treykey Green G1 and it runs on an Intel Celeron Gemini Lake J4125 quad-core CPU on 8GB of RAM and 256GB of internal storage. It also comes with a DIY SATA expandable storage bay. In this review, we take a look at its hardware specs and features. Then I'll install a couple of alternative operating systems such as Android x86 and FireOS to show the various possibilities you have with this model. So stay tuned, that's up next. Welcome back. In the box, you get the Green G1 mini PC itself. You get one 4 feet 48 inches HDMI cable, a 12 volts 2 amps DC power adapter, one pack of mounting screws, and a user manual. This model comes with dual HDMI displays, two USB 2.0 ports, dual gigabit LAN ports, the DC power input and exhaust vent to the rear. At the front, it has two USB 3.0 ports, one Type-C port, a headphone jack, an LED power button and a clear CMOS pinhole button. On both sides, it has intake vents. And below is where you'll find two anti-skid rubber strips, screw holes for mounting the included bracket, and four screws to remove the bottom panel, which gives you access to its internal components and the SATA expandable storage connection. So I'll close this up and set it up on my 4K TV that I'll be using as my monitor for this review and continue. So I'm back. And I've completed the Windows first startup wizard by connecting to my home Wi-Fi network and logging into my Microsoft account. Once that was done, I was presented with my brand new Windows 10 operating system. And if we take a look at its basic system information, it shows that the device is called the Green G1 and it runs on an Intel Celeron J4125 CPU with a basic clock speed of 2.0 GHz. It has a boost clock speed of 2.7 GHz, as I will show later in the video. It has 8GB of RAM, and this is a single DDR4L module, which means you can upgrade to either 16, 32, or 64GB. It's a 64-bit operating system, and its Windows keys are activated. So to give a little more details, the Ada 64 Extreme app shows that its CPU is a quad-core Intel Gemini Lake clocked at 2.6 GHz. Its GPU is the Intel UHD Graphics 600. Its system disk is an M.2 256GB SSD. Its dual-band Wi-Fi adapter is the Realtek 8821CE model. It has Bluetooth support, and here's its BIOS information. I attempted to update to Windows 11 and at first it was unsuccessful due to the BIOS missing the TPM 2.0 requirement. However, I reached out to the manufacturer and their support team was very helpful and immediately provided a BIOS update that solved my issue. So here is the Windows 11 system update information. This mini PC has dual HDMI ports that can be used to connect two monitors at the same time for extended screen display, ideal when working on personal projects or office type applications. On this mini PC, you can use all your office applications for work and educational purposes, and you can also connect it to a projector and do PowerPoint presentations. You can watch Netflix in HD quality with surround sound audio. However, you don't get 4K. You can watch YouTube in 4K 2160p at 60Hz resolution. And I'm surprised that when you set it to 4K, YouTube doesn't freeze up as seen in similar models. and you can connect your gamepad wired or wirelessly via Bluetooth and play some light to medium graphics intensive games.
That's one way to get in another racer's head.
Let's now take a look at its benchmarks and where it places on the rankings chart. It scored 164,961 in the AnTuTu benchmark. In the PCMark 10 benchmark, it scored 1,678. These are the results of the Geekbench 5 CPU benchmark. These are its Wi-Fi and LAN speed tests. These are its Nova Bench scores. And these are the 3DMark GPU graphics benchmark. After entering the scores on my mini PC ranking chart, the TriggerKey Green G1 is at position number 3 in reference to PCMark 10 benchmark scores. You can view this chart on my blog using the link in the description below. So that's a brief summary of what you can do when updated to the new Windows 11 operating system. So here I have a 1TB SSD installed into the SATA expandable storage compartment, and I will now attempt to install Android x86 as a separate operating system, and it will utilize 100% of the hardware resources without affecting the Windows installation. So after tedious trial and error, I finally found a mobile version of Android x86 that achieves 98% compatibility on Intel mini PCs. This version is Bliss OS Android 11 version 14.3 with emugaps. I will place the link to this ROM in the description below. When you install this version, the first and most important feature that works upon startup is audio via the HDMI port, a problem that notoriously plagues mini PCs when you try to run Android x86 on them. The other great feature you get is full access to the Google Play Store with Google Play services. Just a quick note about Google. And that is, when you start the ROM for the first time, you need to give it at least 15 to 20 minutes to automatically update Google Play services in the background before attempting to add your Google account. This delay can cause one to assume that Google Play services are not working. The next fantastic feature of this firmware is you get root access by the way of the Magix application. Just keep in mind, there are some apps that Magix don't grant permissions to, especially those that attempt to make changes to the root file system. In terms of performance, you get access to this PC's full CPU boost clock speed of 2.7 GHz, and you also get 64-bit ABIs, which will allow you to play 64-bit apps and games. For those familiar with tweaking the CPU's performance using a kernel auditor, with root access, you can set the CPU's scaling governor to performance. Its internal cooling fan keeps the system cool around 50 degrees Celsius on idle, and I will monitor in a moment how it does on the gaming. And surprisingly enough, you get one surround sound audio decoder, which is DTS audio, and I will test this in a moment. You get Netflix and Amazon Prime Video in basic 480p resolution. You get smooth YouTube video playback at 1080p. If you set the resolution any higher, it will freeze up. You can play 1080p video smoothly, but you don't get HDR, Dolby Vision, or 4K display. 4K video starts to play, but they freeze up all the time.
Build weapons that I couldn't even imagine.
And here I have it connected to my audio receiver, and it's not producing any surround sound formats. So this means, in spite of the firmware having DTS, the PC's audio adapter must also have surround sound decoding. You can connect your gamepad and play 32 and 64-bit Android games in decent quality without overheating. And here is a quick slideshow of its benchmarks. So that was Android x86 on the Green G1. However, you can do even better when you install another operating system called FidoS. FidoS has become the king of alternative operating systems for Windows mini PCs, and it's very compatible with the Green G1. If this is the first time you are learning about FidoS, you can view my video tutorial in the description below. So this is FidoS version 12, and I was able to install the Android subsystem and root it successfully without any tedious trial and error. With FidoS on the Green G1, you get 4K display up to 2160p at 60Hz, and you also get screen rotation. You don't get HDR display or Dolby Vision. You get audio via the HDMI port without issues, however, you don't get surround sound audio formats. You get Wi-Fi and Ethernet LAN working, and you also get Bluetooth working perfectly. You get full access to the Google Play Store and Play services via the Android subsystem, and you get full notifications bar to the bottom right corner here. You get Netflix and other premium movie services in HD if you play them through the Chromium browser. However, you don't get 4K. You get YouTube in 4K 2160p via the Chromium browser. You can play 1080p videos without issues, but you don't get 4K or surround sound audio formats. And you can connect your gamepad via Bluetooth and play your favorite Android games. You only get gamepad key mapping through the 64-bit version of the Panda key mapping app, as the 32-bit versions don't work. And to keep things nice and cool, its internal cooling fan ensures that there's absolutely no overheating during gaming. And viewers, there you have it. This was my review of the TriggerKey Green G1 Intel Windows 10 upgraded to Windows 11 mini PC review. This model is very similar to the one I did in my last video from B-Link, with the exception that this one comes with a Type-C port and two USB 2.0 ports. So if you are interested in this model, you can get it at an affordable price along with a discount coupon using the links in the description below. Thanks for watching. Give this video the thumbs up if you enjoyed the presentation. If you are new to this channel, be sure to hit the subscribe button along with the notifications bell before leaving to keep in the loop as to when I release new videos or decide to do a giveaway. Thanks again for watching. Stay tuned, and I'll be seeing you in the next one.